being in the dark in our respective life is also important. It is the time wherein there is no light, there's an absence of light. And for me, I can describe this as a time wherein I am fearful, the time that I am lost, I am confused, I don't find meaning in everything that I do. I wanted to be detached from anyone, I don't want to face anyone. And even the time that like to give up on those things that used to be important to me. And in our respective lives, it's also part, there are really times that we wanted to be, but we'd like to choose even to be in the dark. And during this time, it's a crossroad. It's a time, a situation that we need to make a decision. Where would I like to go? Where can I find life? Where can I find meaning in my life? And so, in this darkness, I can describe it that it is also the absence of light and the absence of life. I remember when we went to Panimahawa Ridge and we had an overnight camp together with my students, is that we just lie down, it was really dark, it was dark, but you can only see the lights in the city and the neighborhood, neighboring places. And then when we lie down, I was able to see those stars in the skies. And I came to realize that, wait, these stars are there all the time. But during this dark time, during this night, I can see them already. But we know for a fact that these stars are in the skies all the time. Whether it's a day, whether morning or afternoon, it's there. But because it's too bright already, we can't see this anymore. But during that night time, I realized that, wow, these amazing stars in the skies are there. And so the same with our life. Light, this light or life, is already being presented to us, given to us. But sometimes we just need to be in the dark so that we'd be able to see these things, to start to appreciate this and to have to crave it, to crave for it, to have eagerness to, I want this, I want this light, I want this life, so that I won't be able to stay in the dark. And so friends, that's how it is. If we don't have God in our respective lives. In the gospel today, Jesus said to his disciples, I tell you, everyone who acknowledges me before others, the Son of Man will acknowledge before the angels of God. But whoever denies me before others will be denied before the angels of God. During dark times, it is also the time that we can acknowledge the presence of God. But it's just human as we are. It's a human feeling that we do have. But mind you, Jesus, life, the light, the stars, like the stars, is always there. He's there in all the days of our lives. And during these dark times, there's a time we could even say, Lord, I want you. I want you to move me. I want you, Lord, to use me. I want your life, Lord, to be in me so that I continue to keep on. To continue to rise up in this battle. And that's my life. And that's how I see darkness, friends. And so whether when you are in darkness today, whatever situation you are in, especially if it's in the dark, mind you, Jesus is there. God is there. Crave for it. Want it. Pray for it. Ask for it. And He will give it to you. And you have other people who would be there for you. May you continue to be blessed because God wants to use you to bless others. Have a great day.